Hello, 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 and welcome to the Propel Activation Program. I'm Megan DiMartino, and I'm so excited you're here today. I have been developing this for 30 plus years, and I am so thrilled to be able to bring this to you today. I don't know how many people are on Facebook right now, but I am going to get started so we can get into it. That way, you'll take full advantage of this hour. We're going to start off with the program, but then at the end, for the last 20 minutes, we'll have questions and answers. My associate, my producer, my graphic designer, Elizabeth Hauser, is here with me today, and so she's maneuvering all of this. But without further ado, I'd like to start.
You got what it takes, you can win. Today is your day to begin. Don't give up here, don't you quit. The moment is now, this is it. Because today is your day, and everything's going your way. Today.
Today is your day. We're going to begin. And this is the start segment for the Propel Activation Program. And I call it a program versus a course because it really is a activation of your life and your business. And I'm going to integrate both of these. Now, if you haven't received vis-a-vis email the PDF, Elizabeth is going to put it up on the group. That way you can follow along. Now, this PDF for the first piece of START, and let me go into that. There are two modules in the course, and the first is START, the second is SCALE. And then the third will be a mastermind, and that's called SUSTAIN. But we're going to start off with START. And it's based on the five C's, that are the principles that I work with in my life and my business. And it's clarity, courage, confidence, commitment, and compassion. Now, each module will, start and scale will be broken down with the five C's. But today, we're going to start with clarity. Because if you are not clear, you will do nothing. Now, again, I'm going to go back to the PDF. The PDF is part of the course, but not, meaning that I wrote this specifically for the masterclass, but some of the material in it, of course, is part of the workbook for the module START and then the section of clarity. Okay, so this piece today, we're going to focus on clarity. Now, clarity to me, as I said, is all important. And you hear about clarity all the time. I know you do. I'm on Clubhouse. I read books. I'm in watching podcasts. And everyone speaks about clarity. Why? Because if you're not clear, you will do nothing. I've always said to my staff and people that I've consulted with and trained that clarity leads to power. Because if you're not clear, if you don't know what or why you're doing it, you're not going to do anything. So it's imperative to have clarity. Now, in the PDF, it goes through and it's interactive. So I'd like you to take it out. And there are questions. I'd like you to just pay attention to those as I'm speaking and sharing some anecdotal stories in reference to clarity and the essence of it. And I break clarity down into your vision, your mission, and then your passion. And your vision is, you know, what you see. Mission is believing it. And passion is what makes you go. So it's that vision, what you see. And then that mission is what you believe. And, you know, as Napoleon Hill says, burn the boats. If you didn't believe in something, you could not do it. And then passion is that juice. It's what makes you go. It makes you alive. It makes you want to get going every day. So it's that vision, mission, and passion. And so vision is a tricky one because you say to yourself, you know, I want to be a speaker. I want to be a coach. Okay, that's great. And it doesn't mean you have to spend thousands and thousands of dollars to take programs and courses and things. I'm not saying you shouldn't. Don't misunderstand. We'll go into that in different modules. But the bottom line is, or sections, I should say. But basically, you have to identify what your dreams, goals, and desires are, what they are. And again, so many people have dreams and have goals and have desires, but they never write them down. They never become clear. So therefore, each year goes from year to year to year, and you don't actualize anything. You drag along that bag of dreams, goals, and desires, that vision that you think you have, but you've never written them down. You don't have goals, because a dream, a goal, a desire not written down is just a wish. So you have to be clear. That's why, again, clarity leads to power. I'm going to say it again and again and again. You have to understand the why of why you're doing something. It is that clarity. So I'm going to share a little anecdotal story about this essence in reference to my life and business, but life. And I shared that too, because I want you to own this. I want you to think about business and life. People start businesses all the time, regardless of type of business. It could be a brick and mortar. It could be a direct sale business. It could be, let's say you're a physician and it's a business, so to speak. That's a business. But it is that business. But then you forget the component or the piece to life. As my friend Sharon Lecter always says, if you do not pay attention to having a life with your business, you may not have a W-2 anymore, but you have a job. So it's very, very, very important to really pay attention to that, to integrate your life, dreams, goals, and desires, and your business dreams, goals, and desires, and they must align. They must align, or you will just be creating another job. You have to, again, that's where that passion comes in. You have to be passionate about this, what you're doing, or it will not work. I always say, if I believe in something, I can sell anything. Because to me, sales is not manipulating people. It's about information. I don't want to get off into that. This is not a sales program here. It's about gaining clarity. But what I mean is with that is if you believe in it, you can do it. As the PDF says, a quote from Napoleon Hill, and I'm going to quote Napoleon a lot, and Zig Ziglar and Jim Rohn throughout the course and program. I've been their student for years, Og Mandino, many others. But whatever the mind of man can conceive, can see it and believe it. So whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe, he can achieve. But you have to see it and believe it. It's that vision and mission. See it, believe it. Otherwise, you're going to go from one thing to the next. You can change jobs, you can change careers, but the essence of those, if you look back on your life, will have a similarity of the flow of them, the congruity of it, the synergy of it, because it is, if you're in that flow of your vision, your mission, and your passion, then they will flow, they will evolve. My title, you'll see on the PDF, is Megan DiMartino, CEO, Chief Evolve Officer. I've called myself that forever. And my corporation, Megan DiMartino Creative Business LLC. And because businesses and life always evolve. So I've been in the spa space for many, many years, as long as it has been in the world that we know it today. Just a little bit about my early career, I have been in the beauty fashion industry all my business career. As a little girl, speaking about passion, I have always been a creative. I was rearranging my furniture in my bedroom and taking sheets and creating drapes. And I was the one that did the plays with the neighbor kids. I would, on some level, if my mother let me, I would do I wouldn't say redecorate, but I would move things around in her home. I kind of made her crazy with that. But I was the creative. So I've always known that. And I've always known that my passion was to create. I thought I was going to be a fashion designer, but God had a different plan. And it just was part of my life story that is in my book, Hope and Possibilities Just Over the Horizon. But as time went on, so I was clear on my passion, because if I don't create something, and that could be as simple as getting dressed in the morning, thinking about it, creating it, I can't even breathe. It's part of my DNA. So my passion is creative. So I knew that at an early age. So as I said, my career has always been in that direction. Fast forward many, many, many years, I entered the wholesale beauty industry in sales and marketing in the early 80s. And I worked for my family's business. My dad wanted to add some products to the beauty division. And and my job was to figure out what the salon needed in reference to paper. They were paper converters. My father and his business manufactured N-wraps. If you've ever had a perm, you've seen the stylist use an N-wrap. With that said, he wanted to add some products to the beauty division, so my job was to figure it out. So during that season, the nail industry was beginning to evolve, and we put together a non-woven toweling for the acrylic industry. And so I learned through that experience the beauty industry, the relationships, and the way it worked. In 1987, I was recruited by Alcon Laboratories, and they moved me to Fort Worth, Texas, to my daughter's chagrin to this day, you know, even though her life would be very different if that had not happened, but it was not easy for her at 11 to move to Texas. But we moved to Fort Worth, Texas in 1987, and they had purchased a lab that manufactured hair products, which was very new for them. And these were serious NDC-coated products, national drug coating. So they wanted to repackage, reposition, and add new products. So my job was the national sales and marketing director for this division. I took that job for one reason, probably two, but one reason specifically, because I wanted to work with very sophisticated chemists so I could learn about how products were put together. Because in those days, guys, there was no Google to go into. There were no YouTube channel information. There were no podcasts. There was nothing. So I needed information, because by this point, I had decided I was going to do a skincare brand. And so remember, passion, creating. So I learned through doing in that career path. I still didn't say I was going to early on when I was before joining my family's business. And during that season, I didn't say, oh, I was going to develop a skincare line. What I said was I wanted to create something, not just paper. And that intrigued me. And the second reason moving to Texas is I was always intrigued by Texas, always loved coming here on business. And so I thought it would be a great adventure and life change. So we moved to Texas, as I said. So I was able to hang out with very sophisticated chemists and learn about ingredients. During that season is when, and I'm not going to go into the story of why of that, but it was a reality that I learned in there that I was not going to make that a career decision in life. So it was time to start my own business. So in 1991, I left and had a lot of information about glycolic acid, alpha hydroxyfruit acids, called labs around the United States, and found one that was doing R&D, research and development, and put together my first brand, Glycolic, I launched in 1992. During that season, I got my aesthetic license in the state of Texas, and I was off to the races. I introduced Glycolic the summer of 92 to the wholesale beauty industry that I had worked with my family's business, as well as with Alcon Laboratories. And it shot off like a rocket. Why? Because it was introducing result-oriented skincare. I was the first person to use that term because it wasn't just an emollient base. It had ingredients that were active and did something. So I introduced this result-oriented product. Avon, in the spring of 92, introduced their product, single product launch of a product called Anew, and to this moment is their most successful single product launch of their 140 years of business. And that was a glycolic acid, alpha hydroxy based. So I would say vision by that point was getting clearer, and mission was to help others build their businesses, meaning to introduce to the salon industry skincare. Spa didn't even exist. So it was to introduce to the salon industry skincare and then help them, because as I said, I was a licensed esthetician, but even if I wasn't, I would have been training, because I could have done that without a license, and educating the salon how to get into skincare. So over the next 5-6 years, I did just that, and Glycolique built. I ended up selling it to the lab that manufactured the products because they had tried to get into the wholesale beauty industry and they failed miserably because it was very small and very relational. And I had been involved in it for over 10 years now. And so I had built relationships. Again, that's going to be in other modules of starting and scaling, certainly. But meaning building relationships. But I want to focus on the clarity piece. So during that season, when I sold it, I ran it contractually for them. And then I started again in 97, my brand Novita. Novita means new birth, new life, always something new. And then I decided after several years of building Novita that it was time to do a spa. And to me, that was going to be more of a training, R&D type of business, and attached to my warehouse, which was also in Fort Worth, to do an education center. So that was really my vision, because the industry was changing. Distributors that I had been with, I'd been with most Matrix and Redken houses throughout the United States, and they were all being sold. They were a little bit, the owners of them, were older than myself, but ready to cash out because they had been family owned for centuries. So it was time for them to do that. So Alberto Culver approached the Matrix houses, and Alberto Culver owns all the Sally stores that you guys know of and throughout the United States. And L'Oreal bought all the Redken houses. So the industry was changing. So I decided it was time to change with it, to evolve. But I was always very clear on my vision, which was to build this brand and introduce it to salons and spas and educate. And my mission was to help others identify their dreams, goals, and desires and help them build their businesses. And my passion was to create. I was very clear on that. And so at that juncture, I said, this is time to evolve. Today, people call it pivot. And I was looking to buy an existing salon in Fort Worth, and I found one, and it was perfect. And I shared it with someone because I was going to have a hair component to it, you know, salon component, and then expand it to spa and skincare specifically, and then evolve it to medical. That was my vision. And someone shared that, what I had found this, and someone bought it underneath me with cash money. So guess what? That didn't happen. God had a different plan. I call it God moved the furniture. And so those pivotal moments when that happened, but I saw very quickly that why that happened, because I was supposed to be in the Austin, Texas area, but I didn't know anybody, didn't know one human being, not one. I had a warehouse and a manufacturing in Dallas, Texas, a warehouse in Fort Worth, Texas. I lived in Fort Worth, Texas, but my daughter, who had moved to Texas with me, had moved to Austin. And then at that 2003, my first husband's parents were really in need of help. And I had extended that, but I knew that the Austin market or area was more conducive for them. My mother-in-law had Alzheimer's, and he needed help. And so I knew it was too much for my daughter. So I said, you know what, let me test this market and see. So I took a one-room studio, and that's the backstory. This is the story to you. I knew that it was time to do this, meaning to evolve from doing just selling to directly to salons through wholesale beauty distributors and helping them grow. It was time, because the market was changing, just like the world is changing now. The market was changing, the beauty industry was changing, but I was foundationally instrumental in helping salons get into skincare. And then by the late 90s, it was the spa dynamic was beginning to evolve. And so I knew that now it's 2003, that it was time to do this. So my manager at my warehouse was very capable of running that herself. And I stayed with some distributors, but then I tested the market in the Austin market, found this sweet little town called Georgetown, and tested that market and came to it, found a one-room studio in a hair salon, Rachel and Company, and started Valentine's Day 2004. Didn't know a soul. Said to Rachel, the owner, Rachel, can I borrow your rollabout? And she goes, well, sure, why not? And I said, may I talk to your clients? Of course. So I took my alpha-beta peel and put it on the rollabout, had a bowl of water, my brushes, and I would roll it around and introduce myself to these gals that were sitting under the hairdryer or waiting on an appointment or waiting on someone and asking them if they would like to have a hand peel on one hand. So I share this story to you, is that you must be clear on your vision, your mission, and your passion. Otherwise, it will not happen. So I came, didn't even live in Georgetown, Texas yet, had not decided to make this move. I wanted to test the waters. I came when I was not traveling with the distributor business and trade shows. I came and I built a base of business. During that season, I really knew that it was time to make that move. And so I did. I came up to the Georgetown Square, historic Georgetown Square, and I met during that year that I was driving back and forth before I sold my home and moved to Georgetown permanently, so to speak. I met a woman who had a interior design business in Georgetown, and she and her husband were coming up to the square to a much larger building and asked me if I wanted to join them because she knew my vision of being on the square. So she and her husband and I carved out about 1,000 square feet. So I started in one room, built a base of business, but knew before I even came to Georgetown that if I did come, I was going to be on that historic Georgetown square. So she knew that vision, invited me to join them, and then I came up to the square. We opened together July 5th, 2005. So I started Valentine's Day 2004, built a base of business, started advertising it, Novitas Spa at Rachel and Company, and now came up to the square and called it Novitas Spa on the Square. It was in the building with Diva, but regardless, we were there. So again, so I'm going to stop now and say, there are so many people that feel that they have to have everything perfect before they start. And they don't have that clarity of that vision, mission, and passion. Therefore, they'll never take action. So as I shared in one of my intro pieces, that lack of clarity is really one of the culprits of procrastination. And procrastination is one of the true culprits of truly destroying your ability to get clear. So you put it off, you put it off, you put it off. Oh, I'll start Monday. I'll look at this. I'll take another course. I'll do this. I'll do that. Get clear. Get clear. When you are clear, and that's why I drilled down deeply in this PDF. I want you to do these exercises. Because they're basically going to make you think. They're going to make you go within, because if you do not go within, I mean, for instance, myself, I have been wanting to lose weight. I would say, when I say lose weight, I've gone up 10 pounds, down 10 pounds, but I've wanted to change my lifestyle. And Glenn Lundy and the Morning Five has helped a lot with that. If anyone has been a rising grinder and now on Clubhouse, that has helped a lot, meaning changing, because I used to stay up way too late and I would always, to wind down, I would have a glass or two of wine and not exercise. So I had to change those habits and patterns. I had to go within and truly, really pay attention to that, because I am committed to my health. I'm committed to you, because your health is your greatest wealth. Without health, you have nothing. And so as I'm getting older, in chronological age, time around the sun, I'm committed to being the healthiest, the best possible vessel I can be for you. But back to this anecdotal story, is that if I wasn't clear, A, I would never have gone from the one room to the 1,000 square feet. And then I had a sublease with them. And then in 97, my husband, Paul Matthew Tyler, and I, who I married in 2006, we took the building two doors down, which was just a blank slate, and we started the remodel. And the boutique was the first piece, which was the entry, so to speak, because this was a walking square, and I have a product line, and so we made it a shopping boutique. And then when we were getting ready, I was getting ready to fulfill my sublease with the interior design business Diva, we started the finish out of the back portion of the square footage, which actually had become the warehouse for the product, because in 2007-08, we closed the warehouse in Fort Worth, and because my manager was moving, and it was just perfect timing. So the back was my office and the warehouse. And so we were there for about a year and a half, and then we started the finish out of the Novitas Spa on the square, which ultimately became the Novitas Spa and Medical Rejuvenation Clinic. Because remember, I said my vision, mission, and passion, if I had had that business in Fort Worth, if I had consummated the purchase of that salon and also added a spa to it, was going to have a medical component to it as well. So medical wellness dynamic. So I've evolved this business over the years. It didn't stay static. I didn't stay with one thing. I evolved it to what the market bore, meaning what they were interested in, and what, you know, and I say that also because in the latter 2008-09, the economy was softer. Texas was pretty strong still, but it was, nationally it was softer. And Georgetown itself had not become the bedroom community of Austin that it is today. So it took until the 10, 11, 12 to start working on that component. But by 12, Q3, 4, we got our licensing, got everything in check, and launched in 13 the medical rejuvenation clinic portion to the business. So I call it a hybrid. It's a whole other story, but an other piece. But the truth, or the essence, I should say, not the truth, the reality of this for you is that I had to be very clear on my vision, my mission, and my passion, and take as Tony Robbins says, take massive action. If you do not take action, nothing happens. Even with the beginning step of going within, that self-awareness, renewing the mind, all of those pieces that I have on the PDF, do that. Whether you get involved with the Propel activation program or not, meaning the whole program, this PDF will help you begin 2022. That's why I was so committed to doing this before the first of the year, because I wanted to help you gain clarity on what you're currently doing. You may be in business right now. You may be. You may be in a brick and mortar. You may be saying, you know, with the climate of business today, I need to evolve this to more of an online source, or maybe I need to change it totally. So I got to a place with this evolution of the business, as I shared with you, the hybrid, which is combining a luxury day spa, which it was, and clinical and medical aesthetics, which it was, as well as wellness, which it was. And that was predicated on, we did stem cell in rejuvenation therapy. We had infrared saunas, a steam room. It was about health and wellness. We did a lot of classes, a lot of workshops. So we combined it all, but it was one-stop shopping. And it had that, as I said, that never, I should say it this way, it never lost its essence of a luxury day spa. So, you know, it is a hybrid, and it's the hybrid concept that I train people with today. So anyhow, in 2020, you and I know exactly what happened. And I guess in probably March, the lockdown happened in March, but in the early part of that, I started doing lives with my staff. I called it the pop-up shop to keep them engaged. And, you know, Gigi doing peels in her bathroom and Sarah doing eyelashes and on and on. And I could see that people were enjoying that, and they certainly were as well. Then I started what today is our podcast and live called Unique Leaders Live, where I interview other people and they share their stories. These compelling stories of who they are, how they began, where they began, and their lives' journeys that will enable you to see that you just don't become Scott Simons or Glenn Lundy or Sharon Lecter, who I have interviewed on Unique Leaders. And their stories are on YouTube as well as all the iTunes and all the podcasting platforms. But we started that in March, end of March of 2020. So one day, we had just finished, Elizabeth and I had just finished filming, and in those days, we filmed in the boutique of this spa, the Novitas Spa, and I was about to leave, and this man knocked on the door. I thought he wanted to buy a gift card or some product or something, and because we were still selling that, as long as FedEx was open, I was there. I never went dark, not one day. I was always there, shipping products all over the country because people would buy online. So I opened the door. He identified himself and said, would you like to sell your business? Excuse me. And so, but the interesting thing about it, guys, and I'm going to share a little secret with you, is that I had been thinking vision, mission, right? And passion. I had been thinking that it was time to possibly change the model of this business. Never not the hybrid, but to bring it more to health and wellness. And this is before COVID, because the stem cell therapy was so well received by the area. And our medical portion of this business was so well received that I felt it was time to shift and change the focus and the model. And then, as I said, COVID happened. So when this man knocked on the door, it was a perfect opportunity to do an asset purchase, which was the equipment and so forth, the lease of the building. But I said, I'm not interested in selling the trade name, Novitas Spa, which is federally trademarked, not interested in selling the product, not interested in selling the URL, which I'd had since 97, and the website and the like. So that is what we did. And so here I sold, June 2nd, 2020, a business that I had been building, guys, since 2003, essentially, and launching it in Rachel and Company in one room in 2004. And so I sold that business. Now, in 2011, when Paul went home to heaven, many of you have heard this story. But as the day was dawning, because he passed in probably 2, 3 in the morning. And as the day was dawning, the backyard. I was in my kitchen. I had made a cup of tea, and the backyard was full of white butterflies. And I was like, Lord, I knew I had not been hallucinating. I knew I was there. I said, Lord, what are you trying to say to me? And I put my head down on the kitchen table and started to pray and talking to God. And as I raised my head, I heard a voice in my spirit say, share your story. Share my story. I said, what story? Tonight, Paul's passing, a journey of illness, my life story? What story? Well, God doesn't answer those questions. So over the next years, I started journaling. And in 17, I wrote an outline, and it had a title, Hope and Possibilities, which I've been using for years in my education, to spas, my staff, to salons, helping them get into skincare and so forth. So, and then the tagline, just over the horizon, is actually my dad, Ray DiMartino's famous mantra. He's one of my mentors of life. And so it was hope and possibilities just over the horizon. And then I didn't do anything with it. And then the couple of years went by. And in 19, in the fall, I started working on this course, Propel. Wasn't called that, but I was working on this business course because I knew in my spirit, guys, that it was incumbent upon me to share information that I have gleaned and built these businesses with over the last 30 plus years. So I started working on this, and then all of a sudden I felt this, you're not doing what I told you to do. What is that? The book. So I put the course down and started writing, and it just flowed out of me, put it up on Amazon in December, around the time of this week right here. Latter part of December after Christmas, and put it up on Amazon, and it went to number one in four categories in the business section, in the business category, on January 4th, which is my mother's birthday. And so that had already happened. That was January 2020. Now, fast forward to selling this business, and I consulted for a bit for the gentleman that bought the business. But in the fall of 20, I started working on changing the website to not a spa site. So Elizabeth, who has been with me 8 years, my graphic artist, videographer, very talented woman, like my daughter, we started working on that. But mind you, I had been doing the podcast already, the live already on StreamYard. And I said to Elizabeth, it's time to make this a podcast. So I started doing research on that. And one day I said to her, do you realize what we're doing? And she said, I'm not sure. And I said, we're building a new business. So evolving one more time. See, I didn't go from beauty. I didn't go from what I did over to something else. It's evolving. In the spa, it evolved from a true day spa, luxury day spa. We won Best of Georgetown every year, the gold, which is the number one slot, for years of day spa, even though I was evolving it to clinical medical wellness. People identified it as a luxury day spa, which it is, and it was. So it is evolving. It's not changing your course. It's evolving. It's working with what you have. But it goes, what your dreams, goals, and aspirations are, what your vision, what your mission, and your passion is. It goes back to clarity. Clarity leads to power. If I wasn't clear on all of this, I would have aborted so many times. I mean, there are so many pivotal stories in these years that I'm sharing here. I would have aborted this and said, nope, too hard. Nope. I don't have enough money. Nope. But I was compelled to continue because I'm clear on my vision, my mission, my passion, and my purpose. We'll go to purpose another time in the start course. But I want to stay today very focused on clarity. So I evolved so you can be doing a myriad of things, many things. But if they align with your vision, your mission, your passion, your values, your goals, because, you know, values are important in every aspect of life. And I also want to bring that back to what I shared in the beginning, is that the reason this is called Propel Activation to start, this is the start module, it's to build the business and life of your dreams, is because your life has to be aligned to your business. So over all those years, that, and it was 18 to be exact, before I sold it in the June of 20, was that I was a passion of mine. Every day I was down there and building my team and supporting my team and leading my team and working with the guests. There's a quote in here, or a thank you, I guess you'd say, in the note page from two of my lead estheticians who have left, and they're both medical estheticians, and both have started their own businesses since me selling the asset purchase. And both of them, Bridget Gloria, if you go to her website, you'll see her use the term special pampering attitude. That is my trademark. That is, and I allowed her to use it, meaning that it stands for an acronym for a spa, a special pampering attitude. From the moment you say hello, whether they walk in the door or on the phone, to forever. It's an attitude. It's a philosophy that was conveyed. But again, that's a whole other point, a whole other day, a whole other module, a whole other section. But what I want to share is that philosophy is congruent to the training that she got through her 8 years of being at Novitas Spa Medical Rejuvenation Clinic. She also uses the term result-oriented. I shared that earlier, that I never trademarked that, but I should have probably, but a little tricky to do that. But it is a phrase that I have been using, or a description I've been using for 30 years since I launched Glycolique, result-oriented skincare, simple, safe, synergistic. So I want you to own today, as we go into questions. I hope there are people here. I have no idea. I've been sharing with you focused on the camera, but I want to, and I can't see, so I have to now put my glasses on with you. But the PDF is for you. It will be up on the Propel Masterclass Facebook group. Replay of this is up on the Masterclass. It's up on the Propel Masterclass Facebook group. It'll stay there. We're going to be going into pre-sale of Start, and that we'll talk about that a little later. But I just want to let you know that this is a little taste of what that is. Basically, it's each, not only module of Start and Scale, but each section of Clarity, Courage, Confidence, Commitment, and Compassion are broken down separately with workbooks. And there's, I do a video on them, and it's working with you. So this is similar. It's not exact, but it's similar, because I'll be talking to you about the questions that I want you to focus on in these, very similar to this. But I wanted to take just an hour of your time today and share the essence of this, my heart, why I'm doing this, and share a little bit about myself, and then about the why of this program, propelling you into your greatness, propelling you into your future, propelling you into tomorrow, propelling you into next year. So I'm going to close with this. That this year, 2021, I started working on this course in February, March. I had gotten involved with a mentor and worked just because I just wanted to have, again, someone with me, so to speak. Big change, 18 years going into, meaning not selling through wholesale distributors anymore. So all of that has evolved. I still sell we sell throughout the United States and export. We just shipped an order to the Barbados, Virgin Islands. So we ship all over the country and the world, so to speak, the Novitas Spa clinical products. So that is still, but a big change, not going down to that spa every day. So in the fall, yes, I said to Elizabeth, do you know what we're doing? Building a new business. But I knew this course was going to be part of it. So in February, March, I started working on this again. And I worked with a mentor. And I wanted to just get clarity on this and the direction of it. Was I going in the right direction? And this mentor absolutely felt that this was spot on and this is what needed to be. So I started working on it. I got to June. I had filmed in Fort Worth with a studio that I had worked with the podcasting and Nexum Designs. And I always love plugging everyone that I work with. And Paul is an amazing engineer and just very talented guy. And so I was working with Paul and doing the filming for these modules. And so I went up, three times, I believe, and did filming. And we actually did the audiobook for Hope and Possibilities during this time. And so that was done. But Elizabeth and I are both not electronic geniuses of how to put all of this together. And I had been interviewing some people, but they had expertise in one area, but not another. And I didn't want to continue to waste money. And so I then was praying about this. And it came to the fall, September. And I was on Clubhouse one evening. And I met this gentleman, and his name is Fred Gillen. And he has a marketing company, More Marketing. He's in Brisbane, Australia. So we have to do our work in the wee hours or of the morning or night for me because of he's in a day ahead. But he has helped Elizabeth and I pull so much of this together with his knowledge and with his expertise. And so the course, as I said, is going to be available this month. It's in pre-sale right now. So the PDF is up on the Facebook club, as well as the replay of this will be up on the Facebook group, as maybe I said club, but Facebook group. I'm all in Clubhouse here. And so the replay, the PDF of Clarity here, right here, as well as then the link to purchase the program. Of Propel Activation Program. Start and with the five components, clarity, courage, confidence, commitment, and compassion. So I hope that this gave you some clarity on what this is about. I know that you will really benefit whatever place you are in your life. I was on a podcast recently. I was being interviewed by this man that had been in the finance world for 15 years. And in the early part of COVID, he had lost his job. And he said to himself, what am I going to do? But he did a clarity exercise on some level and said that I don't want to go back to what I was doing. And I really don't want to be in that space. And so he started just interviewing people. Now I spoke to him just recently again. I was interviewed by him last year and then again recently. And his whole business has evolved, but he got clear enough. He gained that clarity that he did not want to go back to that space. And he was going to take some time to see what he wanted to do. And that is what I want to give you, this opportunity to, whether you are rolling and moving and grooving in what you're doing and happy, happy, there is always that evolution piece, always. So it's that start and then scale is that evolution, and then sustain, as I shared earlier, is going to be a mastermind, but you have to go through start and scale to be part of that mastermind, because I want people to be aligned together in that place. You can continue being growing in what you're doing, because you're always going to be growing. It's never going to stop. That is the point. I want to be here for you to help you identify your dreams, goals, and desires and gain clarity on those, and then to actualize them. And that is what Propel Activation Program is about. To start with this first module, and again, clarity, courage, confidence, commitment, and compassion. And one of the main components of compassion is compassion for yourself, to give yourself a break, to give yourself grace, to say, it's okay that I've made so many mistakes, because I have had to do that again and again with myself. But I have not ever lost that vision of what I wanted to do and that mission, and then that passion. Again, the vision was to, the passion is to create. Once I identified it was what I've been doing, that's why I shared kind of a long story there of my essence of how I got to developing a skincare brand. But I probably will sell this piece of the business in the next 1 to 2 years. And then evolving again into the health space. But that's because I'm clear on it's about that component, product, commodity, helping others with it to then help them see themselves, that mission, and then develop that passion for it, understand it, or not do it. Because if you don't know your why and you're not passionate about it, you won't do it and you will not stay with it. So you need to, whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe, he can achieve. So we're going to take a break, and we're going to just play a little the intro, because I think it's appropriate before we start the questions. And I can't wait to hear your questions, and let's go from there.
You got what it takes, you can win. Today is your day to begin. Don't give up here, don't you quit. The moment is now, this is it. Because today is your day. Going your way today, yeah. Oh, today, today, yeah. Today.
We're back, and the camera got a little wonky there, so we're going to adjust that. Now, this is the same studio. You'll recognize the backdrop is my home, and I'm in my studio portion of it. And this is where we do Unique Leaders Live. So, Marcus Ellis, thank you for being here, my friend. And Fred Gillen, thank you so much. And Camille Walker. And if anyone has any questions, I would love to answer those. Anyone who is with us on Facebook, just put it in the chat. And now, what is that piece right there?
Oh, that's just the link.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So I don't see any questions. I don't know if Marcus is still with us and any other people. But what I'm going to do now is just share again, because this is being recorded and people will benefit from this as well. So with that, and if people want to ask any questions, please do go into the chat and ask away. But the other piece to clarity, and let's go through the PDF a bit, is really going within. Because now I'm going to drill down to the third page, which is the three steps to begin your road to clarity. And going within. And I mentioned earlier a bit about, you know, wanting to lose weight. Well, that was what I wanted to do. You know, that was the desire to lose weight, but it wasn't just weight. It was to gain health. And so I had to go within and really do some soul searching on why I was not completing that. why I was doing the proverbial, oh, Monday or tomorrow. And I had to go within and say, you know, to myself that, do you really want this? Is this something you really want to do? And I finally realized that I was, I didn't want it enough. I didn't want to make those slight changes. Actually, they're pretty big changes, meaning getting up at 4 a.m. versus going to bed at 2 a.m. So you can't, as Glenn Lundy talks about his sleep cycles, you know, exist on one sleep cycle. So, so someone is asking, how much is the program? The program, which is also in the link of it is in the group, is $297. And there's going to have, again, in each section, clarity, courage, confidence, commitment, and compassion, there will be different pieces to it. So there'll be some add-on values to it. But the course, you know, when I was really exploring to see what, you know, people charge for courses, and the price point was all over the place. But I want to make this so affordable for you that you can really not only afford to purchase this, but benefit from this, and then take this information and use it. It's not just pie in the sky. It's not just rhetoric. It's tangible tools. It's just like this PDF to drill down, to go within, to make these changes. Because without change, nothing will happen. Nothing. Because, meaning, I'm talking about clarity. Yes, nothing will happen. But without, you know, wanting to lose weight, if you keep speaking, saying tomorrow, next week, next month, or, you know, when the spring comes or it gets cooler or gets warmer, you're not going to make those changes. So I have been slowly, and that's the other piece. I talk about grace all the time, that compassion piece, to know that you don't have to make these changes all at once, but it's a journey. It's not a marathon. It's not a sprint. It's a marathon. It's a long-term commitment to making changes. And that's why I shared the story of the evolution of the spa dynamic, because it's from one step to the next step to the next step, but you must start. That's the most important piece to it, but you have to go within. The next piece is knowing your why. And again, I shared about this. If you do not know the why, it's sort of like putting off, you know, if you don't go within, because going within first helps you identify that why. But if you don't have a why, then you're never going to start. You know, as this says in this piece here, a confused mind says no. That, you know, if you think about it, clarity leads to power, as I share here. And that gives you that understanding that you become powerful. But a confused mind, if you're not clear, that it will waffle and vacillate. And so it's imperative. I tie it together also with scripture, because the word of God is the roadmap to life. It's the best self-help book there is. It's the North Star. It's giving you that information of, again, clarity and the why. And every piece of life has a point to it, in verse and point in it in the Bible. Self-awareness, you know, I shared earlier, you know, that you have to listen. Clarity is a renewing of the mind, Romans 12:2. I didn't go into this in depth, but in the fall when I was getting frustrated, was I ever going to complete this? Was I ever going to be able to really bring it to the masses or bring it to anybody for that matter? And was I able going to be really able to do that? And so I got in my car and I drove to the hill country of Austin, or the, you know, of Texas. And there's a little town there called Fredericksburg. And Fredericksburg is one of my favorite little towns, and it's just a sweet little place. And I drove a couple hours to Fredericksburg to be quiet, because I wasn't sure if this is what I was supposed to do. Maybe I wasn't supposed to do this. Maybe I heard wrong. And so I drove to Fredericksburg and I just had dinner and I sat at the bar and was meeting town folks, and I stayed at this hotel I normally stay at, and I had breakfast where I go often, but I'm normally with my girlfriends. And so I was just with me. And I, at breakfast, I was reading, and I heard seed, time, harvest. And I knew then, not at that moment, but as I was pondering on seed, time, harvest, that yes, I've put a lot of seed into all of this, 30 plus years. Time, for sure. Harvest, I've harvested a lot. What are you saying, Lord? It's just like, share your story. And then over the day, I went to some favorite little spots, and there's a garden there that I love walking and in, and just some other things. And so then I continued to pray. And then I was driving back, and it's a beautiful drive. And I heard, go home, get going. And the next week is when I met Fred Gillen. And as I shared, I met Fred on a Friday night in a clubhouse room. And it was just, it's too long of a story of how that happened. But basically, God connected the dots, seed, time, harvest, to put that together. And from there, so that's September, and this is the end of December. So we've had a lot of work to do, but, and we've been working on other projects as well. But this project here, I knew, as I knew, had to be completed. Whether one person buys it or 100 million people buy it, it does not matter to me. My purpose is you. And I learned that, my purpose. Years ago, I didn't realize it was my purpose, but when I was 26, I needed a car and I needed some money. And I was in a negative place in my marriage, and I needed to really make some changes. It's, again, too long of a story, but I was introduced to Tupperware, became a Tupperware manager, and had my car, my Ford LTD station wagon, and saved then to purchase my own car when I was, and because I knew I was not going to do that forever, because I also knew I needed to change and change that marriage or that marital situation. So I've been a single parent since I was 30, and I've built these businesses by myself since I was 30. And but during that season of Tupperware, and I say these businesses because I include that, I recognized during that season, because to become a manager, I had to recruit six people. They became my unit. And then I was a manager, got my Ford LTD station wagon, and went on from there. And I learned during that season that helping these people identify their dreams, goals, and aspirations, to identify them and then help them actualize them. Most of the women that I recruited were older than I, much older than I. Most of them had different dynamics, such as being a single parent or wanting to provide for college educations and things of that nature. So I helped them drill down, identify what their needs were, and help them actualize it. So it is really a very important piece to the why, is understanding that that self-awareness, but also that listening, as I shared about with meeting Fred, to go to Fredericksburg and really understand that I had to complete this. That was that self-awareness. I had to. So God had to provide. He had to move the furniture to help me meet Fred and put this program together. So between Elizabeth Hauser and her Chirpy Graphics, which is her company, and Fred Gillen, More Marketing, and myself, we have, and then of course the gentleman that filmed the modules that you'll see, and which are really well done, that and that is Anexum Creations and his filming company. And we've put this together, and this will be available to you very, very shortly. So we're in a pre-sale now. I want to just talk about it. I will also have it up on this Propel Masterclass Facebook group where you can come, you can watch this again, you can get the PDF, you can share it with others, you know, because I really would like you to do that, to share this, invite people into this Facebook group so that they can watch this masterclass on clarity, get the PDF, work on this, spend this next week with this. This is Tuesday, the 28th. Spend some time with this. Spend some time just really going within all of these exercises that I put here for you to really understand and get clear on what you want to do. Because as I say in this, you may not know. You may not know. But I want to help you get to that place of knowing, to a little bit, that seed, to know what you want to do, but you have to go and understand what you don't want to do. Often the exercise to do, and we'll go into this in the module, but is to take a legal pad and do one side of the draw a line in the middle, one side what you want and what's the other side what you don't want. That's a great exercise to do, and we're going to be doing that in the clarity module. But you must really focus on that to see what you want and what you don't want. And often what you don't want helps you to what you do want. It's just like the guy that I told you about with the podcasting, that he recognized, I don't want to do that. I've done it for 15 years and I really don't. I love people and I love doing this type of work. He was talking more social media and podcasting and developing other things from that. But he did not want to go back, even though he was somewhat in sales, let's call it that, with financial services. He did not want to do that. So he's taken some time and now he's not only started, but he has scaled and he's now flourishing. So it's about being clear. It's so, so important to be clear. So again, we have this up for you. And so it is now a little after 11. I said we're going to be on for an hour. We have. So I am going to close this now. And I so appreciate you joining us. So Elizabeth has put up the link to the course. Estefania, hello, hello. Welcome. Well, you came in right as we're ending, my love. But this Estefania LeBaron is a person I have interviewed on Unique Leader. She was actually one of my first interviews. So she's up on YouTube and she is an amazing woman of courage, of valor, of creativity. She's also a videographer and just a beautiful, just charming woman. But so Estefania, this is the masterclass for my Propel activation program. And this masterclass will be available on, now that you're part of the Facebook group, you can rewatch this. You can share this out with others as well as, invite people in, I should say, to the group. And also the PDF is also available in the group. And this is Propel activation program. And the first module is Start. And there are five sections based on clarity, courage, confidence, commitment, and compassion. And today's brief introduction to the clarity section is what we've been going over today. But the PDF is there. So do just download it, Estefania, and just really drill into it. I think it'll help you get clarity for 2022. So without further ado, I'm going to end again with a song that we played during this because I think it is so important to know that this is your day and just start. Be blessed.
Because today is your day and everything's going your way. Today.